a new session at Graduate Guru. We are on our topic redemption of preference shares, and today we'll be seeing how to do the sum based on redemption, and we'll be starting with the first sum in this session. Okay, so first, last session mein humne dekha that kaun si entries hame karni padti hai, and when we were doing the entries, I explained to you that jo transfer to CRR hai, jo humne entry number 10 mein dekha tha, transfer to CRR, that is a very important entry because wahan pe hume ek amount determine karna padta hai that kitna amount CRR mein hum transfer karenge. So for that, whenever we will start with a sum on redemption, we will make two equations. So what are those two equations? The first equation will be for face value of redemption. Okay, face value of redemption, and second equation will be for premium on redemption. Okay, there are two main elements in our redemption. Yeah, hum face value pay karte hain, obviously. So 10 rupees share, we are paying 10 rupees, that will go in face value, and we will also have a premium because we are not going to redeem them at par. Not necessary that every time 10 rupees ke share par hum 10 rupees hi denge. We always give our shareholders something extra. So that something extra is nothing but our premium. So for face value, I will obviously take the number of shares, multiply by face value per share. So this will be our total face value, and premium ke liye it will be number of shares into premium per share. So if it is 1 rupee premium, then 1 rupee. If it is 2 rupees premium, then 2 rupees. Or premium ke liye there is one more way of calculating. It could be given as face value into percentage of premium. Sometimes premium is given as a percentage. Some may bolenge that the redemption is at 5% premium, 10% premium. So tab hum kya karenge, jo hamara face value already calculated hoga, us par hum wo percentage use karenge. Now for face value, I have two things which I can use. One is fresh issue and the other is divisible profits. Okay, now fresh issue may be given to us in the sum or it may be missing. We have to calculate. Divisible profits will be given in the sum, but usme se hume kitna use karna hai, wo diya hoga ya nahi diya hoga. So each sum will have a different approach. Okay, so either both the amounts may be directly given to you, or one of these amounts will be missing and we will calculate it. Okay, but what we have to remember over here is fresh issue ki entry hum alag se karenge. Or jo bhi amount hum divisible profits se use kar rahe hain. Now divisible profits, I am not making a list again. We already know. But generally sum mein do main divisible profits jo diye honge, that will be general reserve and P&L account. So usme general reserve mein kitna use karna hai, P&L mein kitna use karna hai, that breakup we will show. And whatever amount I am writing in divisible profits, that amount will be transferred to CRR. So this equation is important for that reason that jo bhi hamare paas divisible profits hoga, usme wo amount directly jayega CRR mein. So which divisible profits we are using, that also we will write when we are writing the equation, and we have to remember that divisible profits wala amount will go to CRR. So this will be used for our entry number 10, which we had seen in the last session. Okay, so that is why this equation is important. For premium on redemption, I will first use divisible profits. And if divisible profits are less, then only I will go to security premium. And that also, which security premium? The old one. Jo already amount diya hua hai, wo. Jo hum naya fresh issue pe hume agar security premium mil raha hai, you cannot use that. Companies Act debars you from using that security premium for the purpose of this premium on redemption. Okay? So, these are the two main equations which we will be making at the beginning of every sum. So, har sum mein agar ya to hume journal puchi jayegi, ya hume balance sheet pucha jayega, okay? Ya dono cheeze puchi jayengi. And before we start doing the journal entries, what we are going to do in each sum is making these equations. So, take down these equations and then we'll go ahead with the first sum. So, let's read our question number 1. ABC Limited has 60,000 11% redeemable preference shares of rupees 100 each fully paid. So, yahan par jo bhi shares diye hain, 60,000 shares hain and they are all fully paid. The company decides to redeem these shares on 31st March 2019 at a premium of 5%. So, as I said, hamesha we will have a premium on our redemption. So, yahan pe percentage diya hai, which is 5% of the face value. For the purpose, the company makes the following issues. So, yahan pe do issues diye hai. Let's see which are those. First one, 1,50,000 equity shares of rupees 10 each at a premium of 7.5%. So, the new issue is also at premium. And this is an issue of shares. So, this will qualify for our redemption. So, redemption mein, jo hum part fresh issue mein use karte hain, fresh issue use karte hain for redemption. This is of equity shares which will qualify. And the next is 15,000 13% debentures of rupees 100 each. So, even though this is a fresh issue, but ye fresh issue kis cheez ka hai? Debentures ka. So, entry we will pass because ye issue karne se the company will get some money which they can use for redemption. But this is not an issue which will qualify for redemption. So, ye hamare equation mein nahi aayega. Why? Because it is not of shares. It is of debentures. Aur hamara section 55 jo hai, it clearly says that the fresh issue has to be of shares. Okay? Both these issues were fully subscribed and the amounts were duly received. So, we will be passing entries for these fresh issues. The company also sold investments having book value 50,000 for rupees 65,000. So, company ke balance sheet mein kuch investments the which was shown at 50,000 and we have sold them and we have got 65,000. So, that's a profit and we'll pass entry for sale of investment. The company had the following balances on the date of redemption. They've given us some few reserves. So, let's see which reserves they've given. P&L account diya hai, general reserve, dividend equalization reserve, revaluation reserve, security premium account. And they've also given us bank balance, which is obviously not a reserve, but they've told us bank balance hai, which we can use for our payment. So, yahan par jo 5 reserves hame diye hain, usme se first 3, P&L, general reserve and dividend equalization, I can use for my redemption. Revaluation reserve is an indivisible reserve, non-divisible reserve, I will not use that. And security premium, agar hame zarurat padegi, to hi hum ye security premium use karenge. Otherwise, no. Assuming the redemption is carried through as per the provisions of the Companies Act, pass journal entries for the above transactions and also show a note on reserves and surplus after redemption. We know in our new format of balance sheet, every amount that we show in the balance sheet, if there is a detail to it, agar usme details batane ki zarurat hai, then we prepare a separate note. So, yahan par hame sirf note kis cheez ka manga hua hai? Reserves and surplus. So, that particular note we'll be preparing at the end of the sum. So, let's begin the sum. We are going to pass some journal entries first. So first we have two issues. One is of shares and one is of debentures. So pehle hum one by one us issues ki entry pass karenge. So our first entry will be for the issue of shares, and the issue is at a premium. I will get money for the issue. So bank account debit to equity share capital account, and it is at premium, so to security premium account. This is our entry. Now let's calculate our amounts. We have issued 1,50,000 shares of rupees 10 each. So equity share capital ke samne aa jayega 15 lakhs, that is 1,50,000 into 10, that is our number of shares. And the premium is given as 7.5%. So 15 lakhs ka 7.5% is 1,12,500. That's our premium. So the total amount that we will get on issue of shares is 16,12,500. Okay, so this is our fresh issue of shares. So being equity shares issued. Okay, so first I am passing the entries for the basic things that they have given. Then when we come to redemption, we will move to equations first. Okay. Next issue is of debentures. Again, we'll get some money. So my second entry, bank account debit. We are issuing debentures. And what is the rate of debentures given? 13%. So to 13% debentures account. Entry is similar to our issue of shares. Okay, but here we use the word debentures. We are issuing 15,000 shares and of 100 each, and this time they've not given premium. So it's at par. So 15 lakhs again is the amount which we are getting on issuing debentures. So being debentures issued. Okay, so two issues jo hame diye the samme, we have covered that. Now they have said the company has sold investments and book value is 50,000, selling price is 65,000, so it's a sale at profit. So third entry, for the sale of investment, we'll get money. So bank account debit. Bank account is always debited with the selling price, which is 65,000 in our case. To investments account, and investments account or asset account will be credited with book value, jo ke diya hai 50,000, and the profit obviously goes to P&L account. So the difference between the two, which is 15,000. This is sale of investments, so being investments sold at a profit. Okay, so these are our beginning entries which are not directly related to our redemption. So ye hamari teen entries ho gayi, do issues and one sale of investment. Now we'll go to making our equations, and in that equation we will see hame kitna redemption ke liye amount chahiye. So let's make two equations over here. One is face value of redemption and second is premium on redemption. For face value, we will use fresh issue plus divisible profits And for premium, we will use first divisible profits. And we will use security premium if needed. And that also with security premium, as I've always specified, don't forget that it is only the old security premium. Now, for filling up the amounts, we'll read the beginning of the sum. Jo hume diya tha beginning mein, ABC Limited has 60,000 preference shares of 100 each. So that is what we are going to redeem. So 60,000 into 100. So that's our face value, which is 60 lakhs. Okay. And what have they said? Redeemed at a premium of 5%. So, jo bhi hamara face value hai, uska 5% becomes my premium. So, 60 lakhs into 5%. That is 3 lakhs. So, our premium is 3 lakhs. So, we have the two amounts which we need. अब ये जो फेस वैल्यू है उसके लिए आई कैन यूज फ्रेश इश्यू एंड डिविजिबल प्रॉफिट. सो लेट्स गो बैक टू आवर एंट्रीज. एंट्रीज में फ्रेश इश्यू वाज ऑफ शेयर्स आल्सो एंड डिबेंचर्स आल्सो, बट डिबेंचर इश्यू कैन नॉट क्वालिफाई फॉर रिडेम्पशन. जो नया इश्यू होना चाहिए, जो फ्रेश इश्यू होना चाहिए एज पर सेक्शन 55 ऑफ आवर कंपनीज एक्ट, इट कैन ओनली बी ऑफ शेयर्स. शेयर्स कैन बी इक्विटी और प्रेफरेंस, वो दोनों चलेंगे, बट डिबेंचर्स इज नॉट अलाउड. सो आई एम ओनली अलाउड माय फ्रेश इश्यू ऑफ इक्विटी शेयर्स. नाउ यहां पर भी द इश्यू इज एट प्रीमियम. सो इन दिस इक्वेशन व्हेन आई हैव टू टेक द अमाउंट ऑफ फ्रेश इश्यू, दिस फ्रेश इश्यू अमाउंट कैन ओनली बी द फेस वैल्यू एंड नॉट द प्रीमियम. सो फेस वैल्यू इज 15 लैक्स व्हिच आई कैन यूज ओवर हियर. सो 60 लैक्स जो हमें टोटल रिडेम्पशन का अमाउंट चाहिए, फ्रॉम दैट 15 लैक्स विल कम फ्रॉम फ्रेश इश्यू. ओके, सो द बैलेंसिंग अमाउंट विल कम फ्रॉम आर डिविजिबल प्रॉफिट्स. सो टोटल 60 लैक्स माइनस 15 लैक्स जो कि फ्रेश इश्यू का है. सो 60 लैक्स माइनस 15 लैक्स, माय डिविजिबल प्रॉफिट्स व्हिच आई एम गोइंग टू यूज इज 45 lakhs. I'm circling this because that is the amount that we have found out. Fine. On this 45 lakhs ke liye, let's see what are the reserves we have. In the sum, later in the sum, they have given us P&L account 15 lakhs, general reserve 40 lakhs. Plus, we should not forget that hamara P&L increase hua hai. Already balance sheet mein P&L diya hai 15 lakhs. Balance sheet in the sense, they've given us a list. Plus, I have made a profit on my investments of 15,000. So, in this divisible profits, first I'm going to write P&L. P&L already jo balance hai mere paas, which is 15 lakhs. Plus 15,000. What is this 15,000? This is the profit made on the investment. Okay? So, 15 lakh plus 15,000, 45 lakhs mein se nikal jayega. The balance amount I will use from general reserve. So, let's calculate that. 45 lakhs minus 15 lakhs minus 15,000. General reserve se amount aa jayega 29 lakhs 85,000. Which is more than enough. हमारे general reserve में हमारे पास है 40 lakhs. If this was less, तो I would have used the third reserve, which is also a general revenue reserve or a divisible profit, जो हमारा दिया है dividend equalization reserve. But यहाँ पे वो use करने की जरूरत नहीं है. Now coming to premium. For premium, as I told you, first I will always use divisible profit. अगर divisible profit कम है, तो ही आई एम गोइंग टू यूज सिक्योरिटी प्रीमियम. नाउ हियर हाउ मच डिविजिबल प्रॉफिट डू आई नीड? 3 लैक्स. हमारे पास जनरल रिजर्व था 40 लाख. 40 लाख में से आई हैव यूज्ड 29,85,000. आई स्टिल हैव बैलेंस ऑफ 10,15,000 इन द जनरल रिजर्व. मुझे चाहिए कितना? ओनली 3 लाख. सो दैट फुल 3 लाख विल कम फ्रॉम जनरल रिजर्व. सो आई विल राइट डाउन 3 लाख एंड दिस आई एम गोइंग टू यूज डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम जनरल रिजर्व विच आई हैव इनफ. सो आई डोंट नीड टू यूज एनीथिंग फ्रॉम सिक्योरिटी प्रीमियम. दिस इज हाउ वी फॉर्म आर इक्वेशंस फॉर रिडेम्पशन. Once the equations are formed, my entries become very simple. Now I simply have to use these amounts and pass my entries. So let's go to our entry number 4 for redemption. Our preference shares are 11%. So I will cancel those shares. I will redeem those shares. So 11% preference share capital account debit. We are also giving them premium. So premium on redemption account debit to, we have to pay this full amount to the preference shareholders. So to preference shareholders account. Ab ye amounts kahan se aayenge? 60 lakhs. कैपिटल 3 लाख प्रीमियम. सो प्रेफरेंस शेयर कैपिटल के सामने 60 लाख, प्रीमियम के सामने 3 लाख एंड टोटल 63 लाख इज पेएबल टू द प्रेफरेंस शेयर होल्डर्स. बीइंग प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स रिडीम्ड, okay, so this is our entry for redemption. Now after redemption I have to transfer to CRR. So transfer to CRR mein kya aayega? The amount which we have used from divisible profits. Kaun se divisible profits humne use kiye? PNL and general reserve. So as I told you when we were discussing the entries, we will not write divisible profits, we will write the name of the account. So over here my 5th entry for transfer to CRR, we are using PNL account. So PNL account debit, general reserve account debit, and we are creating the new account which is capital redemption reserve account, CRR account. So PNL mein I will write this total 15,15,000. And general reserve mein 29,85,000. So PNL will be 15,15,000. Your general reserve will be 29,85,000. And total 45 lakhs will go to CRR. Okay, so here we will just mention so that you don't get confused. 45 lakhs jayega CRR mein because 15 lakhs has come from fresh issue. Fine. So here I'll just write a narration. Being profits used for redemption transferred to CRR. So that is our face value. So face value pura ho gaya. 15 lakhs ki entry already humne kar di thi in the first entry. And now we have passed the entry for the divisible profits. Now there is premium. And wo premium hume adjust karna hai. So our next entry, entry number 6. We are using what for premium? We are again using our general reserve. So general reserve account debit. Whichever profit you are using, that will be debited. And What are we using it for? We are using it for premium on redemption. So, two premium on redemption account. Amount is direct, pura amount 3 lakhs. So, that will go from general reserve. So, being premium adjusted against general reserve. And now the last entry will be for the payment. Hame payment karna hai to the preference shareholders. So, preference shareholders account debit. And we'll make them a payment in check. So, to bank account. And what will be the amount of the payment? जो टोटल अमाउंट हमें प्रेफरेंस शेयर होल्डर्स को पे करना है 63 लाख्स. बीइंग अमाउंट पेड टू प्रेफरेंस शेयर होल्डर्स. So that's it for the entries. Okay, यहाँ पे bonus नहीं दिया है तो I will not assume that a bonus is being made. Okay, so only when they specify we will pass the entries for the bonus. Now we have to do just one more thing, and that is make our note for reserves and surplus. So let's go to that. Now whenever we are doing redemption, so जब भी reserves and surplus का note बनाएंगे सबसे पहले we are going to make our CRR. पहले CRR लिख देंगे because it's a new reserve that we are creating. So if we don't write it in the beginning, we may tend to forget. So let's first write that. So in reserves and surplus, my first reserve will be capital redemption reserve. Here I'm writing the full form. And this will be the full amount that we created over here, 45 lakhs. Okay, write it in the outer column. After that we will see in the sum jo reserve diya hai aur uska kya movement hua hai. So the first one is P&L account, that is profit and loss account. Now here we'll show the movement that has happened. So first हमारा जो बैलेंस था दैट वाज 15 लाख्स. टू दिस आई ऐड माय प्रॉफिट ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट जो हमारी इन्वेस्टमेंट की सेल की एंट्री में हमने प्रॉफिट दिखाया था 15,000. सो दैट आई विल टेक ओवर हियर. And then where have we used P&L? Once we have used it for CRR, 15 lakh 15, and that is it. At one place we have used it. So minus transfer to CRR, 15 lakh 15,000. So this becomes zero. So P&L account ban jayega nil. Next, from our list in the sum we have general reserve. So that also, first we will start with the balance given to us. General reserve is 40 lakhs. General reserve we have used at two places. One is for CRR and one is for premium on redemption. So both we will show. Minus transfer to CRR. That was 29 lakh 85,000 and minus premium on redemption, premium on redemption we have used 3 lakhs. So we'll subtract these two amounts and we'll take it outside. So 40 lakhs minus 29,85,000 minus 3 lakhs, we get 7,15,000. Okay. After that, we have dividend equalization reserve, jo humne use nahi kiya hai. So I will write it as it is. Dividend equalization reserve. Full 10 lakhs. We also have revaluation reserve, which we have not used. Revaluation reserve was 5 lakhs. It remains as it is. And finally, we have security premium of 5 lakhs. There is a slight movement. So I'll write it in the inner column. Security premium account. 5 lakhs inside. And what has happened to security premium? वहाँ पर एक addition है. जो हमने नए shares issue किए थे at premium. 1,12,500. So add premium on new issue, 1,12,500. So our total is 6,12,500, and finally we take a total of all our reserves. So 45 lakhs, 7,15,000, 10 lakhs, 5 lakhs and 6,12,500, we get 73,27,500. That is our total reserves. So this is how you show the full breakup of your reserves. Isme, when you are seeing it from the marks point of view, CRR likhne ke zyada marks rahenge. If you forget to write your CRR, obviously it will affect your marks. So don't forget that, and that is why I always prefer to write it right in the beginning. Fine. Take down this sum and we'll wind up this session over here. Next session, we'll be taking up a slightly different type of sum. Thank you.